my phone once again. I'm outside, watching TV.
Phone's cracked, but it's not as bad as Ryan's, so I'm good.
A tragic event happened yesterday. I was at the movies, buying my ticket, and this happened.
It lasted over a year long, but now it's broken.
Not another one!
I don't even know what happened.
Who needs an iPhone when you have this?
So I dropped my laptop, selling it for $8. Buy it.
Or broke my phone.
Jailbreak is gone.
There's a Vine broken TV!
Goodbye, CD player. You have served us well.
Whee!
As you can see, it's past its use. The screen is broken beyond repair. And it can hardly hold a charge. Goodbye, iPod Mini. Here comes another thing, something that has also been broken for a long time, and I figure it needs a proper burial by being thrown out of a window. A Game Boy Color. This used to bring me hours of enjoyment, but now it's broken. Goodbye, Game Boy Color. Oh, nice! That's broken all over the place.
While most of the portables available today are far less powerful than the typical home or office machine, they are quickly catching up in both memory capacity and software variety.
Goodbye, Facebook.
What we'll do with portables?
If a desktop computer's home is a
desk, still playing.
Where does the portable
computer come from? Try it again.
I think there are two uses. One is
still playing strong. I will continue until it stops.
Before the entry communications was a factor.
Hey,
the other is the new wave of applications that are requiring computer technology to be able to solve a problem.
Is this another case of technology in search of a purpose?
The future of the portable is not all that clear.
A machine this capable, say 20 years ago, would have filled the whole room.
Andy Siebel told me about a concept called jerk and run, which is that you simply can take this machine and go with it right now.
As many of these portables come out, they all, of course, have hopes of great success, but there have been some significant failures in the portable.